Well, one thing about having so much that it's oppressive is that it causes you to put into your vortex what? What do you think that you're putting into your vortex when you feel overwhelmed with too much piling in on top of you?
Nothing.
What you're asking for is more ease, more clarity, more order, more alignment. Focus on ease and clarity. So sometimes, you know what we were talking about earlier, about how this receptive mode turns to these kinds of things, and this receptive mode turns to these kinds of things. And so don't feel bad about it. There are many who, in the not mastering alignment, which is what you all crave and want and relish and naturally know, there is a tendency sometimes to try to fill the void of not being connected here with stuff. And when you think about it, every bit of that stuff you gathered up was a little bit fun when you did it. In other words, you weren't out there in misery shopping. So don't be hard on yourself. Don't look at where you are and say, oh, look at this big mess I've made. Instead say, ooh, a lot of fun was had by me during the process of accumulating this mess. It was the path of least resistance for me in many steps along the way. In other words, it was something to focus upon, something to think about. It was something to do. And so don't beat up on yourself, because beating up on yourself or being mad at yourself for the clutter automatically takes you to a place that you can't have clarity. And do you know, you can have clarity even in clutter, but you've got to step back from it a little bit. The clutter that we feel in your vibration is not about the physical manifestations. The physical manifestation, of course, is in your way, but it's the absence of clarity that you're really feeling, and the clutter just seems like a representation of it.
Yes.
Just like someone might be having an argument with someone and blaming that argument for the way they feel, when really the way they feel is the reason for the argument. So the way you feel is the reason for the clutter. So it's not likely that you could just box it all up and ship it all off somewhere, because there's a lot of stuff in there that you want. And it's not likely that you will have much success in trying to sort it out right away, because when you sort it out, you just get more bogged down in it. Think how many times you've tried to do that and how you've just made a bigger mess and then closed the door and walked away from that.
Yes.
Sounds familiar, doesn't it? And so what you're wanting to do is to get into the receptive mode, and then, and the first order of business to get into the receptive mode is you've got to stop beating up on yourself about it, because you can't find clarity when you're mad at you. You can't say, oh, look at this big mess I've made. I seek clarity in order to clean up the mess. It's not ever going to happen like that. So start as best you can, and you can't really withdraw from it either, because things that you need and want from this clutter is a daily part of your experience. So you can't really just turn your back and walk away from it either. But you could think more kindly about it. And as you think more kindly about it, you will start to feel your vibration raise. In other words, stand in the middle of that clutter in one of your closets and look at something that you really like and be glad that it's in there. And maybe even look for a few things that you really like and move them all to one part of the closet. Feel appreciation that they're there, and then compliment yourself on all the sifting and sorting you did in order to find these treasures. You were looking the entire face of the earth to find them. It's no easy feat to find these wonderful things in the glut of things that are out. You want to see clutter? Go to any department store. That's clutter. You want to see clutter? Go to Amazon.com. That's clutter. Everything in the world is there, you see? And so you got to be nice to yourself about it first. That's the first thing. And then what you'll begin to notice is that you'll feel different about it, because all you have to do is be a little bit nice to yourself about it, and you'll get an idea about something. And that idea may have enough momentum going, if you're nice to yourself about it long enough, that you'll feel like doing something about it. And before you know it, you'll find yourself moving the clutter away from your experience. We offered a process some time ago. It's in the Ask and It Is Given book, is one of the processes in the back of the book. It's called Clearing Clutter for Clarity. We would like to say finding clarity so that you can clear clutter, not clearing clutter for clarity. finding clarity so that you can clear clutter, not clearing clutter for clarity. So once you're a little bit nice to yourself and you get into a little bit of clarity, you might begin to feel, one of the things that we showed Esther, and it helped her very much, we said, set up some boxes. She likes those banker boxes that you can get at the office supply that have lids on them. Set up some boxes and stand in a room that's cluttered and look at the clutter and ask yourself, is this necessary to my current life experience? Like, am I likely to use it in the next month even? And if the answer to that is no, toss it in the box and into a tape recorder or onto a notebook, write, red bikini that I haven't worn since 1994, box number one. And you can sort of put things that are like each other in the boxes, in other words, magazines or whatever it is, but fill up 10 boxes or 20 boxes with a record of where you put them, so that then later, it's kind of fun while you're watching television or doing something, you can record into some sort of an index or a card file where that red bikini is. If you look under bikini/red and you pull it out and you see box one, you've never lost track of it. So you don't have the feeling that you're going to get rid of something that you may want. But what you'll notice as you fill up those boxes and stack them on a wall somewhere that doesn't matter, or in a storage building or unit somewhere that doesn't matter, you'll notice that you rarely go back to any of that. But now it's out of your experience, you have found more clarity. And then, if you want to, you might just discard all of it. You could realize that box number one holds nothing in it that you want anymore, so you could remove it from your experience altogether. But to say to yourself, I need to get rid of this stuff, before you've had a chance to get into the place of even discerning what you really want to keep or what you really want to let go of, all it does is split your energy further, you see? Mm-hmm. We have played with you in these gatherings before you by saying to you that you are the creator of your own reality and you are all really wanting manifestation of things. And someday we will be having a seminar called De-Manifestation. Because so often you think the manifestation of things is what you really want for your happiness. And we're not saying that it isn't. It is wonderful to have something beautiful that you can focus upon and experience. These beautiful things are an extension of beautiful you and beautiful alignment. We're not for a moment wanting to suggest that things are not spiritual, that material isn't part of the manifesting process of spirit energy. You're out here on the leading edge, and that's what you intended. You intended to turn your aligned thoughts into aligned things. So the question is, how aligned are the things with my current thoughts? And if you're down here mad at yourself, you'll never know. So when you get all tuned in, tapped in, turned on, and appreciating so many of your beautiful things, it will be so easy for you to discern which ones you want to maintain a relationship with and which ones you would like to release from your experience. But the law of attraction will take care of that in a more easy way for you. The ideas will occur to you. And so instead of being at a stalemate or confused or just turning around in circles or spending a lot of time and getting nothing done, instead you will act with purpose and it will unfold easily and it will be fun. And you will find that sometimes repurposing that, there are so many others who are eager for much of what you are no longer eager for. And there's this lovely law of attraction that will move it from you to them in ways that you can't even imagine right now. You see? It's not even about boxing it up and taking it somewhere where someone else can paw through it. That doesn't sound fun at all to you. It's about trusting that law of attraction knows who's looking for what you're ready to let go of. And law of attraction and source energy within you who knows what pieces you are ready to let go of. Some might think that this is a frivolous conversation, but this is the most important conversation that we've ever had with any of you about anything, because you are trying to sort out, you're trying to understand the differentiation between the things that have turned to things, the experiences, the things that have turned to things, and what your true spiritual nature is now. And a lot of what is in your experience does not match who you now are. It matched who you once were, but as you drag it from place to place with you, it doesn't match who you now are. And that really is what this conversation is about. Yes. More than anything.
Yes.
Have fun with this.